Does Teen Titans Go take place entirely inside one of its members' minds? Hi, I'm Jason Inman.
I'm Ashley Victoria Robinson.
And go to Fan Theories, the video where we talk about fan theories from all over the internet. And then after the evidence is presented, we vote likely or not likely on them. We have right here animated theorologist Ashley Victoria Robinson to talk about what, Ashley?
Well, we're going to ask the question, does Teen Titans Go take place entirely in Beast Boy's mind?
Okay, before you click off this video, stop, 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 stop. I know you may be a nerd that is over 20, and you might be like, Teen Titans Go is stupid.
Of course it is, it's great.
Yeah, it's for 5-year-olds. So just chillax, relax. If you've ever actually watched the show and you're a comic book fan, Teen Titans Go has so many deep cut DC comic Easter eggs that for me, I actually find it very hilarious. But also know, it's a show for 5-year-olds. They're not making it for you. So chill the F out. Do you say the same thing about Dora the Explorer? No, you don't. So just chill. All right, let's talk about Teen Titans Go.
Okay, so we can all admit that Teen Titans Go is the lighter, more slapstick, cutier version of the
original
Teen
Titans cartoon. I'm looking
forward to that movie. Teen Titans cartoon.
I really am.
Yeah? Yeah, yeah? Yeah. So this hyper-cute, heavily anime-inspired art was featured in the original series. We did see kind of the Teen Titans Go style first shown there.
Oh, we did?
But
oh,
it was
wow.
Usually during a punchline, during expository moments, or to make fun of one of the characters during a scene of heightened emotion.
Sure.
The original series dealt a lot with the implications of being sidekicks, having to live up to greater heroes, emerging romantic feelings, and self-actualization. Kind of what you would expect from a Teen Titans series starring
sure.
a bunch of like 14 to 16-year-olds.
Mm-hmm.
Now, Teen Titans Go is the, you know, a little less serious, tends to go right to the fart jokes version.
Yeah, it's for 5-year-olds.
Absolutely. This, combined with the cuted up art style, has led some fans to believe that the new series takes place entirely inside of Beast Boy's mind and isn't a direct spinoff of the original cartoon at all.
Okay, so can I stop you right there?
Yes, you can.
It's talking about that it takes place inside the mind of Beast Boy from the original Teen Titans
yes.
cartoon? Okay, cool, cool, cool.
So in the original series, Beast Boy moonlighted as the series' comic relief.
Yes, he did.
If the new series were to take place entirely in his mind, it would make sense that the series would have a more humorous bent. He was also the character who always made bodily function jokes, which, like we mentioned...
He said mama a lot.
He did say
in
mama
both series.
A lot. Yes, and the characters and the characterizations are quite different between the two series, with the exception of Beast Boy. He's pretty much the same
yeah, he really
in
is.
Both of the series.
Yeah.
So characters like Starfire, Raven, and Robin are all way more open about their feelings and their emotions. Yes.
Yeah.
And they're less task-driven and goal-driven than in the original series. Robin and Starfire in the original series, they kind of just hint at their romance. They only see it consummated when they take looks to the future. It's more of a slow burn, whereas in Teen Titans Go, it's a staple of the show. They're not very careful about it. Robin is straight up obsessed with Starfire.
Is Starfire obsessed with him in Teen Titans Go as well?
Yes, and like he's always showing up with flowers for her,
that's
and
cool.
she's always hugging him.
I like
and
that.
Like, it's a very.
Spoilers, they get married in the comics.
Yeah, they do. It's a very Dick Corey shipper happy
that would be
version.
A great sequel movie, Teen Titans Go to a wedding.
To a wedding?
Yeah.
That's cute. That's a huge title.
That'd be a finale.
DC, WB can hire us at any time.
Yeah, we'd love to write it. It's 4 weddings and a funeral, just Teen Titans Go.
There you go.
Who are the 4 funerals? There's only 5 members of the Titans.
They're all
Robin
the bad
survives.
Guys. Of course it is.
Raven... Actually, Tara survives. They all the rest of them die.
Oh, no. Tara can't survive.
Yeah. No, she dies. She
Raven
lives.
And Beast Boy's
dies.
Romance is alluded to even less when the original cartoon was on the air, but in Teen Titans Go, he calls her mama. He expresses his feelings for her.
He calls everybody mama.
She returns them openly. He calls her mama more than anyone else, though.
Well, I've heard him call Robin mama.
I once had a 5-year-old tell me that you could tell they're in love because he calls her mama.
Oh, really?
Yeah, which I thought was weird.
That is very likely evidence.
Very funny. Yeah.
We don't even talk about this anymore. The 5-year-old solved it
there
for
you
us.
There you go, nailed it. Yeah, and like I said, in Teen Titans Go, she has a straight-up crush on him versus the original series where she's pretty much afraid to crack a smile. There's even an episode where Beast Boy and Cyborg go inside Raven's mind and we
yep.
see personifications of her emotions because she cannot deal with it.
What does that have to do with Teen Titans Go, though?
Well, she openly has emotions in Teen Titans Go
okay.
versus
got
the
it,
sort of more restrained
mm-hmm,
version.
Mm-hmm.
Even Tara, who is the villain of the first arc of the original Teen Titans series, falls for Beast Boy almost immediately when she meets him in Teen Titans Go and doesn't treat him like a little kid the way she does in the original cartoon, although there is that one scene where they kiss on the Ferris wheel and it's fabulous. So Jason, do the different characterizations mean that it takes place in Beast Boy's head? Do you think that's likely or not likely?
Are we finalizing the entire theory? Do you have more stuff to talk about?
I got more stuff to talk about.
So I'm just going to be saying very likely and not likely to the same theory?
Okay, well, you don't have to then. We can just move
on. Well, I'm just, I don't want to end the video too soon if I don't have all the evidence. I don't want to make a ruling.
Okay.
I'm a smart judge here. I will just, let's just talk about it very loosely. I don't need to make a ruling here. Let's just chillax there, mama. Okay. Chillax, mama. All right, so, the evidence is very strong.
Mm-hmm.
And the idea that they're more open with their feelings in Teen Titans Go is actually really fascinating. It also just could be really good writing
mm-hmm.
and really good characterizations by the Teen Titans Go writers. The idea of the romances is, the linchpin here, where Terra falls for Beast Boy immediately,
mm-hmm.
and Raven, there's allusions there.
Yeah.
And especially Starfire and Robin's relationship basically being out in the open in Teen Titans Go. That's very strong evidence. I want to hear what else you got.
So if you think about it, if a teenage boy were the filter through which we were seeing the show, it would make sense that two of the coolest female characters were into him almost immediately upon meeting him.
Who do you see as the two coolest?
Terra and Raven, obviously.
Okay.
Right.
That's putting some bias into this evidence.
I'm putting it right here.
Okay.
Don't tweet me.
All right.
The whole cast really just acts much more like Beast Boy than the classic characterizations that we know them by.
Yep.
And if they're all projections of his mind and they're living in his own reality, doesn't it make total sense that they would just act more like him than we're used to seeing them?
Mm-hmm. That is true.
It's also just a really clever, fun way to account for all the production differences that went on between the two shows, because there were, years intervening in between the animation style we talked about.
It was a while, yeah.
Yeah. The animation style is scaled down and simplified compared to the original series, although it is derivative of some of those chibi scenes. But they might represent Beast Boy's distilled versions of who these characters are, or how he might draw them himself if he were the animation director behind Teen Titans Go and the character designer.
Sure.
For example, the two shows even conquer similar plot lines, like the Terra storyline and Trigun, who I like to call Evil Daddy Raven.
Trigun's in Teen Titans Go?
Oh boy, is he ever! And let me tell you the differences between the two versions
of
them.
I didn't know he was in Teen Titans Go.
Yeah, he wears a tie.
I like that.
In the original series...
Is he Tigun?
No, he's Trigun.
No, he's Tigun.
He is a series-long villain that the team bands together and travels through dimensions to beat. Raven has to go inside herself. A lot of their new allies from different teams come together. Trigun is kind of the end-all, be-all villain of the original Teen Titans series. On Teen Titans Go, he's Raven's embarrassing dad who makes dad jokes that she brings to the tower and they all make fun of until he leaves.
That's
he literally
funny.
Wears a necktie. In the original series, his voice is modulated. It's very scary. He sounds like a typical demon.
I have to see some of these episodes.
I'll show you.
This is really funny.
On Teen Titans Go,
Teen Titans Go is good, guys.
He sounds like a boring dad.
This is really funny. I haven't even seen this, and this sounds funny.
And if Beast Boy and Raven do have this romantic connection that I'm a very big fan of,
sure.
He wouldn't want to see Trigun as this really scary demon. He would just want to see him as a weird dad that he'll get his approval eventually if he just works hard enough or transforms into mm-hmm. the right animal. Teen Titans Go also lacks the ongoing continuity and overarching narrative of the original series.
Yes, it does.
Which has led fans to believe that each episode is just a random thought or a daydream that comes into Beast Boy's mind rather than the ongoing narrative of an expansive universe like we saw with the series the first time around. And that's all my evidence.
Okay. Your last piece of evidence there, talking about just the various different episodes being about different subject mm-hmm. matters. That's just production. That can take no place in this theory. Trigun being a strange dad or a boring dad with a tie is evidence of just a funny joke. I don't think that's really evidence of Beast Boy being crazy here. This is interesting. I don't know where to go with this. I kind of feel like I've already talked about this. I feel like this is very likely... because it just fits. It kind of works. Mm-hmm. I actually think the most likely thing we proved today that is very likely is that Teen Titans Go is a good show. I think that's the evidence of this thing. Teen Titans Go is a good show. That's going to be... I want that across the screen. Teen Titans Go is a good show. Very likely.
Should the people watching this video... watch Teen Titans Go.
Yes.
Very likely.
I want to see this very likely. Go watch it right now. This Trigun joke, I haven't seen any of these. I haven't seen every episode of Teen Titans Go. I've seen all the Robin episodes, or the ones with all the different Robins.
Seen the musical episode.
I've seen the musical. I love the musical episode. I love that. I think that song is so good. And I haven't seen the. I just haven't seen the Trigun ones. Mm-hmm. This sounds genius. I like this theory that it's inside Beast Boy's mind, and it'll be interesting to see if this, if Teen Titans comes back to Adult Swim, like has been rumored.
Yeah.
If they do this joke, I actually think that would be so funny.
You just zoom into his head.
Yeah, if just for like
maybe
one.
That's what the movie is.
For one beat. Heck, the movie could do this joke. Yeah. If they cut back to the regular series. Remember, there is an episode of Teen Titans Go where they create, a villain creates an animated series.
Yes.
And for the first time he creates the animated series, he tells them that he has like de-res them and made them stupider.
Yeah, yeah.
And so she shows them the original versions of themselves, and it's the original series.
Yeah.
And they're all like, and they're all transfixed by it, and they're like, this show's amazing. And I actually think that episode's really good. So like, they could actually do this joke. I think our best bet here is to make this very likely is to find all the creators of Teen Titans Go. They're all over Instagram and tweet and Instagram to all of them to make them use this idea. Because with the power of the internet, these guys are very internet savvy, these men and women that make this show. If enough of us tweet at them about, hey, does Teen Titans Go a fever dream of the original Teen Titans Beast Boy? I think they would do it.
I'd love that.
I really think they would do it, even if they do the new Teen Titans series, the Teen Titans Go. So let's just say very likely, because I want this to happen. Go tweet all the Teen Titans Go people. And yes, Teen Titans Go is a very good show. It's a great show. And you should totally watch it and take off your stupid nerd judgmental glasses and open your mind, mama. All right, go down to the comments and tell us whether you like Teen Titans Go or not. If you think Teen Titans Go sucks, I don't care. Click subscribe.
And for more exclusive geeky content, check out patreon.com/Jawin. Come join us in the Hall of Justice and be a super friend.
Don't be mean in the comments. Be happy. Teen Titans Go is really funny. Shut up.